and it's not in. So if you were going to incent people to change behavior, you might incent those ties rather than getting people directly. So let me, a long way of answering, please. So the community that we have, that we gave them all smartphones, we divided the community into two pieces. In one part, we gave them money if they were more active and more healthy. So they had a little pedometer on their phone. We gave them money based on that. And the other one, other half of the community, they had pedometers too, but they also had buddies. And if you were more active, your buddy got money, not you. And so your buddy would, next time you saw your buddy, would say, hey, you're slacking off. You're not making any money. And it would become a topic of conversation. And that turned out to work between 4 and 8 times more effectively than getting economic incentives. So much more bang for the buck. The red balloon thing is actually mathematically very similar. But it may sound different at first. So DARPA about almost 4 years ago, had a 40th anniversary of the internet challenge, which is how to use the social media to be able to do social mobilization in a disaster recovery mechanism. Or you know, a child's been kidnapped, can you recruit millions of people to find the child? And the way they did it is that they got 10 red balloons and they put them up somewhere in the United States, and if you found all 10 of them, you got $40,000. Thousands of teams signed up. We didn't know about it to work with this until like a day before. But it's what we do for a business, so we do it really quickly. All the other teams, and not all 4,000 ended up competing, it was generally just a few hundred competing, all of them used economic incentives, except us. And what we did was we had a dual incentive. If you found a balloon, we would indeed give you $2,000 and give you $2,000 to charity or other teams like that. But we did another thing, which is that if you recruited her, she found the balloons, she'd get $2,000, but you'd get $1,000 for recruiting her. And if you recruited him and he found the balloon, you'd get $2,000 for finding the balloon, you'd get $1,000 for recruiting him, and you'd get $500 for recruiting her. So it all stays within the budget. We stay under $40,000. And as near as we can figure, we recruited something like 2 million people in 24 hours to find balloons for us. In fact, we found all the balloons in about 4 hours. But this was something that intelligence analysts thought was going to be impossible, even in a month. Right? We did it in 4 hours. Then we spent another 5 hours figuring out who was lying to us. And it turned out there was a big cottage industry of people making false red balloon images and something like that. But we still won. So it's this idea. So what was happening with those people? So what was happening with those people is they were being incentivized to use their social relationships, peer-to-peer relationships. If you go one step deeper, it's really interesting because the odds of you making any money off this thing are about zero. Lottery tickets are bad, okay? But still, millions of people signed up. Why is that? Well, if you recruited her, it's like buying her a lottery ticket. You know, she's not actually going to you're not actually going to be like lightning strikes or something. But you've done her a favor. And she's probably going to do you a favor back someday. So you strengthen your social ties. And similarly, what she would do the same. So all these people were doing favors for each other. And rationally, they had expectation of, their expectation of return was something on the order of 1/10,000 of a cent, right? I mean, something like that. But they all got into it. And so it was leveraging that peer-to-peer relationship in that way that generated the